What does Pisces mean? The true definition of Pisces might be deeper and more surprising than the fluff we hear going around. Welcome back to Astrology by 33, where ancient astrology is made young again. It's an honor to have you here today. So what is the meaning of the Pisces zodiac sign? Well, besides the obvious, which is a lot of fish, super big fish, and pretty much everything alive that grows in water, including water lilies, there's a whole lot more to understand about this sign. Now, here are some facts about Pisces. What planet rules Pisces? Jupiter. Now, what's so interesting is that the electromagnetic field of Jupiter actually extends beyond the physical orbit of Saturn. Everyone thinks that Saturn is the outermost planet, but actually, the effects of Jupiter extend beyond that due to its electromagnetic field. And so that's why Jupiter, which rules Pisces, is the last sign of the zodiac. Its effects actually extend beyond the boundaries of Saturn. What color represents Pisces? White. Which house does Pisces rule? The 12th house. And what body part does Pisces rule? It actually rules your feet, which includes your 10 toes. Other scriptures also say that it rules over your left eye. Now remember, your feet are the holding foundation of everything above you. This is a very important sign. The 11 signs of the zodiac all sit on Pisces and they're dependent on it. Without this spiritual foundation, everything as we know it crumbles. Something interesting that a lot of people don't know is that Pisces actually rules over your eyesight and your vision. So all kinds of issues with your eyes, even though a lot of people tie that to Taurus, can be seen from Pisces as well. So let's talk about the true meaning of Pisces. It's one of the keys to decoding the matrix. If we understand all the signs and not just the personality stuff, we're more likely to achieve self-mastery. Astrology helps us understand our past so we can design our own future. So what is the symbol for Pisces? It's actually two fish with their heads and tails interchanged in position. So one's tail is in the mouth of the other and vice versa. And what's the meaning of this symbol? Well, we know it's a fish, and this fish actually represents the first incarnation of Vishnu, also known as Matsya. Now, we all know the story of Noah's Ark and the Flood. This is kind of a parallel to that story. We'll just use Noah as an obvious example. It was basically this giant fish avatar that saved Noah and the Ark from the Great Flood. Of course, this is symbolic. But basically, we know the whole world got destroyed by the flood. Yet the waters rose up and lifted the ark and Noah's entire family. And even though everyone and everything below them was destroyed, it was the great deep waters that lifted them up. And this great fish avatar, he was the one that saved them and tied a long cord to the ark and led them to safety. This is ultimately the greatest liberation. That when the world is ready to recycle, kind of like now, this energy will lift you up and save you. It will bring you out of the world. It will rescue you. Now, this is really important to understand that if you identify as a Pisces, remember that there are 11 other constellations in your body. If you follow Western astrology, you understand that your sun was in Pisces when you were born using the tropical zodiac, which is based on the seasons. Now, if you're using Vedic astrology, it's a completely different thing because the sidereal zodiac is used instead. And that just means that if you look up into the sky and you actually see the constellation of Pisces, the planet is in the literal constellation in the sky as you see it. Also, in Vedic astrology, your moon placement takes on a completely different meaning and will tell you a lot more information. So what does Pisces rule over? one of the main things you'll see is that it rules over foreign countries. This is basically anywhere far away from home. It's going to be out of state or out of country at a minimum. So Pisces energy rules over being separated from where you grew up. It can be living in foreign lands. It also rules over moving or just travel to foreign places in general. It rules over where you sleep, like how comfortable you are in your bed, how elaborate your bedding is. Are you super happy where you're sleeping? Does it feel amazing? That's actually a Pisces thing. It's your quality of sleep and your overall rest. Pisces also is in charge of your thoughts. Remember, the electromagnetic field extends beyond the physical boundaries of Saturn, beyond its physical orbit. So we start to break into the mental realm. In Pisces, we move more towards mind instead of form and the body. In Pisces, we enter more subtle layers of consciousness as you exit the ring of form of Saturn and move to the subtle realms of Jupiter's electromagnetism that can't be seen, but definitely sensed. So, what is the energy of Pisces? Just remember that when different planets enter Pisces, you're going to get different results. All the planets and all the constellations are inside of you, not just the sun or moon. So if you identify yourself as a Pisces, be careful and know that you are the entire zodiac. But if your sun was in Pisces when you were born, using the sidereal zodiac, that quality is going to be super obvious and highlighted in your life. But just don't forget you have all the other constellations in you. If you want your whole body to be full of light, it's good that we attend to and master all the other signs as well. If we just identify as Pisces, it's only acknowledging like 1/12 of ourselves, and we're much more than that. Beginners to astrology, of course, we identify with the sun because it's like putting a massive spotlight on that constellation in you, so everyone's gonna resonate with that. And if you want to know more about the 11 other constellations, I just posted 11 other videos before this one, so you can check that out. The time of day that Pisces rules over is that darkness just before the sun comes up. It's that quiet stillness where everyone's asleep, the astrals are still, and there's not a drop of sunlight yet. It's the very end of the day. So a lot of people want to know, is Pisces a water sign? Yes, it is. It's classified as a watery sign. People also want to know what element Pisces is associated with. It rules over the element of water. So with Pisces, just think water, water, water. Genesis chapter 1 says that water actually existed before creation started. Many people assume, that water was part of the creation project. It actually wasn't. Before anything was made, it said waters were upon the face of the deep. Water was already there. So what does that mean? Water is a programmable substance. It's passive, and whatever you project into it, you can manifest, depending on your level of concentration and your power. Water is the purified substance from which Aries actually manifested. The end, which is Pisces, starts the beginning. And the ocean represents consciousness. And the ocean represents the programmable medium of consciousness. So we know Jupiter rules two signs. He rules Sagittarius, and he also rules Pisces. Now, if we're talking about water in Sagittarius, Jupiter would just give you a bottle of water, which is like religion. Now, in Pisces, Jupiter gives you the whole ocean. It's like, here's the whole thing. It's bigger, it's deeper, it's vast. It's not a fractal, like a little bottle of water in religion in Sagittarius. Pisces, it's like, here's the whole thing. Do with it as you want. It's free. It's liberated. Write your own program. So this ocean of Pisces is the fabric of consciousness for spiritual liberation. It's the launching pad when you want to search for God. This is the highest of the highest in the zodiac. So here's a general overview of Pisces. It's really important to understand the energy of Pisces because each planet expresses itself differently in the sign. So here we want to talk about just pure and raw Pisces magnetism. What is that? Just think of each sign in the zodiac like a magnet. Each sign only attracts very specific things. Pisces only attracts its own little magnet filings of Pisces to itself. This can be objects or events, people, personalities. It'll just be a Pisces thing. And so that's why it's really important to know the energy of Pisces and what it rules. Here's a list of places that Pisces rules over. Number one, watery places. So any place with a lot of water. Number two, places where fish live. Three, the ocean. Pisces is more of an ocean thing, and just know that this sign of Cancer is more of a river thing. Pisces rules over things in the ocean or the sea. Number four, ashrams. These are those faraway places where people go to meditate and live a spiritual lifestyle. Number five, isolated caves. This is like where people go to meditate also, away from everyone and everything. Six, an eerie dark forest far away from civilization and untouched by man. Seven, a wasteland. Number eight, the void. This is that huge big space of nothingness and nowhereness. Nine, a sacred place. For those of you who love Psalms 91, like me, it's the secret place of the Most High. It's where you'll abide under the shadow of the Almighty. This is the place of true spirituality and divinity. It's sacredness in purity and truth. Pisces holds the energy of the most holy place. Number 10, places of quiet stillness. It's the darkness and peace in a good way. It's not the bad, creepy darkness like Scorpio. You know, like when you turn the lights off and you're half asleep and you're just warm and safe and happy and you don't feel anything but bliss and peace and wonderfulness and just rest, relaxation. It's kind of like that hypnagogic state. That's Pisces. It also rules over weather, like rain and thunder and lightning, interestingly enough. The direction in space that Pisces rules over is north. Now let's talk about something super interesting and important. All the signs of the zodiac have something good and bad about them. That's just the way things are in duality. Each sign can be in balance or it can be out of balance. And so the first thing I want to talk about is Pisces when it's in balance. So the first thing, you'll often get asceticism. These are the people who basically have had enough and renounce the world. Not in a bad way. There's no aversion to it. It's just like you've been there and done that. Sort of like when children outgrow their toys. It's not that the toys are bad, it's just that you've outgrown them. You know what I mean? Basically, it's just being done with the world. I know that there's more than this. What now? And so these people will go away from the world. They'll renounce everything for the sake of divinity and for seeking God. And this is what the book of John was talking about in chapter 12, verse 25. It says, whoever loves his life is gonna lose it, but whoever hates his life in this world will find eternal life. This is a Pisces thing. It's just being done with the world. But what's funny is when you lose everything, that's when you gain everything. It's the point where duality starts to merge into unity. It's the merging of opposites. These people who renounce the world in Pisces have a very high level of self-control. They know how to exercise restraint, and they find great peace and joy in being alone. Solitude is their middle name. Pisces rules over these people that go into exile or hiding just to get away from it all. Pisces rules over detachment. This is basically when you don't have a lot of desires anymore. not in a bad way. You're just good as is. There's no obsession with pleasure or sensory stuff. You're withdrawn, you're at peace, and you're just good. Pisces also rules over going away from religion. Now, this is interesting because many people think that if you're religious, you must be spiritual and all that. But remember, religion is only step number 9 out of 12 in the zodiac. It's like the beginner's version of spirituality. And then Jupiter finally takes you up into Pisces later on and gives you the real enchilada. So this tendency that pushes you away from religion, it's not a bad thing. Especially if you find yourself spiritually seeking truth, the ultimate, who am I? Are all the scriptures actually true, or were they just written by man? What's really going on here? This tends to be more of a Pisces thing. The whole ocean is opened up. We're not sitting in the bathtub anymore. And so ultimately, Pisces rules over salvation, also known as moksha. This is spiritual liberation at its finest, at its deepest. It's departure from the matrix and the world as we know it. You hear a lot of people saying, oh, they're awake. This is a Pisces thing. It's like, wake up, people. There are so many people sleeping because they just haven't tapped into this Pisces element. Some people get it from the top down and that's just who they are. And some souls are evolving from the bottom up, to each their own. So Pisces rules over your spiritual awakening. It's that point of self-realization. It's the launching pad for God realization as well. It's the place where people are born again. Pisces rules over evolving out of form. So it goes along with renouncing the world, which is just a bunch of stuff and physical items and people and clothes and cars and money and all that. And as we talked about earlier, as we merge into the realm of mind versus form, structure and boundary, we start to merge into the unseen realms, which are very real and very powerful, but people kind of have a problem with them because they don't know that they're states of consciousness. But you can ascend through states of mind. And even after that, the mind will dissolve too, and you enter higher states beyond that. Pisces continues to raise you up in the water. Go with the flow. So Pisces is the highest point in the zodiac before the great exit. This is where there are no words or labels, definitions, thoughts, debates, colors, or emotions or anything like that. It's pure rest, peace, bliss, quiet, and contentment. The gender of Pisces is feminine. Remember, water is receptive, and the quality of Pisces is beneficial. Now, Pisces is a dual sign. What does that mean? That means it has a moving aspect and a fixed aspect. The energy of Pisces is very strong during the daytime. It's also strong in the fourth house, especially the last part of Pisces. Venus is exalted at 27 degrees of Pisces, and this point where she's exalted is the very end of the sign. It's that unstable portion where you can either glitch out of the matrix and ascend, or you get thrown back into the matrix and you have to start back at Aries all over again. It's that point of cycling where you get in or you get out. And that's part of why she's exalted here. She's exalted at a very high degree of Pisces, the unstable point, which, if you're super devotional like she is, you can be launched out to the higher realms, or if you get sucked back into the matrix, which is most of us here right now. Now, Mercury is debilitated at 15 degrees of Pisces. We know that Mercury is all about talking and communication and words. And when you're dealing with spiritual liberation and the mind, they just don't go together. You can't have a lot of talking and words and writings and all that with spiritual liberation. Mercury doesn't know what to do with himself because he's a manifesting planet in the physical dimension. Up in Pisces, there's no talking, remember. It's just a high state of being. There's also no thinking in Pisces, which is why Mercury doesn't do well in Pisces also. For those of you who know your yoga, too much talking actually makes you lose your vital energy. Your tongue is like an energy dump, so the more you talk, the more your energy gets depleted. And that's why the technique of Kechari Mudra is so important. It basically takes that energy dump, curls it up and back, and your vital energy is maintained. So if you're interested in spiritual liberation, be careful and just aware of how much you're talking. Literally, it's very depleting. And the same thing with thoughts. If you have too many thoughts or monkey mind in meditation, it's almost as bad as too much talking. It's very unhelpful. And if you struggle with monkey mind during meditation, it's best to go back to some of the more basic practices, your pranayamas, your purification, your good action, following of moral code, and of course, your basic yogic exercises. Okay, so for those of you who've stuck around this long in the video, I know you're quite serious. You're probably mature enough to hear when Pisces is out of balance, and you probably know that I'm not talking about you if you think you're a Pisces. These things don't mean that that's what you are. It's just a potential energy of Pisces when it's not working right. So one of those things you'll see is wastefulness. When Pisces is out of balance, you'll see wastefulness, like when restaurants just dump a bunch of food in the dumpster when they could have given it to a homeless person, running way too much water, or just buying stuff that you're never going to use. And another thing you'll see when Pisces is out of balance is angry criticism. You can see people who are cruel or abusive, or just like rude and insulting. It can also include being insulted or blaming people. It's when people just kind of talk nasty. They have like harsh words, they're direct or blunt, they're offensive. This is when Pisces turns the wrong way, like a hot temper. People who are full of hate, they're stubborn or they brag a lot. They like to argue and just disagree. Kind of like those people on social media who have nothing better to do but just criticize you. That's a Pisces out of balance. Remember, that's not Pisces in a good way. And by the way, you can fix these traits too. It's something that can be worked on and corrected. Pisces out of balance can cause people to fight and hurt each other and to punish one another. It can also cause disability, like people who have problems with their arms or legs or they have to be in a wheelchair. That can be a Pisces thing. It can be a very unstable energy. It's subject to change, it's fluctuating. It can be temporary and perishable. Now, one of the big things that Pisces is known for is loss. And a lot of people think, oh, loss is really bad. You know, I don't want to lose anything. That's our initial reaction, right? But if you really think about loss, well, it's just an energy. What if you lose a lot of weight? Well, that's a good thing, right? What if you lose a relationship where the other person was beating you up? Well, loss of that relationship is a good thing, right? So loss isn't bad. And what if it's loss of your job? Maybe it was a job that you hated anyway, and the universe was doing its part to take it away from you, to open the door for something better and bigger for you. So Pisces does rule over loss, but just remember, it's not always bad. It can be, and that's why I'm including it at the end here. When Pisces is out of balance, you could lose things that you love. But there's always a lesson in this. If we lose something, you really want to sit with that and examine yourself. Who am I without whatever it was that we lost, right? Do we define ourselves by the things that we have? Pisces teaches us that. It's like the flood of the great waters. It destroys everything under you. But you float to the top and you realize, oh, I'm still alive. And what truly is important in life? How can we start over with a new perspective when the waters die down? What did I learn from this, ultimately? So this Pisces energy is in charge of disappearance. It's a reduction of energy. That's basically what it is. It could be a loss of money, job, or people in your life. It rules over decay, which goes along with loss. It's the deterioration of something, or its decline. And sometimes we just need to get rid of stuff in order to move on in life. When you're climbing Mount Everest, do you really want to take those 10 pounds of food with you? Or do you need to drop the load just so you can get to the top of the mountain? This is a Pisces thing. How much are you going to take with you to the top? So loss and decay, well, that's a good thing if I lose all that weight. Getting to the top is easier and I can go faster and I'm going to feel better. When I get rid of all this stuff in my life, I am so much happier. I feel better. And what do you need all that stuff for anyway? So it's this emptying energy. It's like when you dump the trash. Do you really miss that trash, you know? Now, for those of you who like to talk science, I love science, Pisces rules over potential energy. So it's not all the stuff that we're using right now. It's not all the energy we've already burned that's been manifested into stuff. It's the highest form of energy, also known as consciousness. It's a very powerful sign if you can tap into it. It's a great sign if you want to manifest stuff. But sometimes it's a lot better not to manifest. You know what I mean. Less is more in many cases. Now, when Pisces is out of balance, you can often run into obstacles or restrictions. You can feel limited or tied in by some kind of boundary. Pisces out of balance can make a person super lazy. Laziness is correctable, but it definitely goes along with this sign. A huge thing that Pisces is known for is spending and expenses. Now, out of balance, people here can have a lot of expenses or just spend way too much. It's where you live beyond your means, or it could mean making a financial sacrifice for something. And just remember, it can also be good. They can be good and worthy expenses if you have beneficial planets in this area. You know, or it can be bad. It could be reckless spending or issues with debt. The spending and expenses and loss, they all kind of go together. So this could be Pisces out of balance. It could include work that you don't like, being in a service position where you're just like, oh, I don't want to go to work today. You could see someone who's just an aimless wanderer. They don't really know where they're going in life. People who don't really commit to any job or any place. Pisces can also rule over the lowest in rank, like the least or the lowest in class. But on the surface, a lot of people would think that's bad. But remember the importance of humility and that text that says the last shall be first. And also the meek shall inherit the earth. So when you're at the lowest or you're perceived to be the least, that's not always a bad thing. Especially with the way the world is today, Pisces out of balance can also be known for evil actions. It's those really sinful people, which can include scandals, crime, fraud, people who tell lies, they cheat, you know, just people with bad morals and bad friends. That's Pisces out of balance, which can include sorrow and suffering and all your hidden struggles. It can be a difficult energy, but so can all the other signs, you know? So don't think that this is targeted to you. It's just a potential energy if it's out of balance. Pisces could lead to poverty or being in prison. Prison is a big thing that Pisces is tied with. It also rules over your secret enemies, and it could rule over being humiliated or having other people against you or just being shamed. That's Pisces out of balance also. Moving back to a positive note, the greatest commandment rules over Pisces. It can be found in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5, and it's also repeated in the New Testament. It says to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. Ultimately, this is the secret to 33. It's the key to salvation. When we truly understand what love is, to embody it, and to give it all to God, that becomes something else. If you want to look deeper into Pisces, determine which house it's in as well, Your house placement will make your reading more precise, specific, and individualized to you. That'll give you way more information than just understanding the sign of Pisces alone. In future videos, I'll be going over what it's like when your sun or your moon goes through Pisces specifically. Today was just about understanding the meaning of Pisces in general, what it rules, and the magnetism it can draw into your life. If you'd like to see more astrology videos from this channel, you can click subscribe below. And for more, you can visit astrologyby33.com. Please share if you think this will benefit someone you know. And as always, please remember to only use astrology as a guideline. Don't use it as anything written in stone. A good or bad planetary transit doesn't mean that anything will happen for certain to you. I mean, it's different for each person. If we turn to God, He'll turn to us. He directs the planets. And like we said earlier in Pisces, if we love Him, He's gonna take care of the planets and transits for us. The bad stuff might not happen to us even if we see it in our chart, so just please don't give your power away to the planets. But we should be aware of what's going on in the sky at all times, of course. Ignorance does not always mean bliss. Not to reduce the negative karma and adverse planetary transits in your life. Strict observance to a moral code, such as the Ten Commandments or the teachings of Jesus, that can go a long way. After thoroughly cleansing the body and the mind with diet, pranayama, proper exercise, yoga, and right action, the daily practice of Kriya Yoga can deepen our relationship with God, and it can also activate our light body. It awakens the subtle body, and it speeds up our evolution. But for those of you on the path, please don't give your power away or bow down to anyone but God. And just remember that God is one. He's not dependent on image. He's exalted above all other gods, including the planets in astrology. A lot of people give their power away to the planets, but really, remember who is ruling the planets. It kind of ties back to the first commandment, "Thou shalt have no other gods before me." Other translations say, "besides me." Regardless, it's all about the one at the top. Or for those of you who know the Kabbalistic tree of life, Keter, focus on the unity, focus on the one. This is the whole of 33 in a nutshell. So remember that you rule your own life and you're given the gift of free will. So create your own reality. You're creating your own karma as you move forward from this point on. Your chart only tells you what you've done in your past. So write your own future. Thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll see you next time. God bless.